मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी एंड टुडे वी हैव व्हाट इज दिस चैप्टर 6 ऑफ क्विडिच. जस्ट यू नो लाइक एवरी ऑल्टरनेट वीक वी गॉट क्विडिच एंड एक्चुअली यू नो व्हाट दिस इज ओके. इट इज डेफिनेटली मच मोर इंटरेस्टिंग देन द फिलर दैट वी गेट इन द मेन स्टोरी. सो actually did play the what do you call it that first house matches beater and I won also, but I did not post the video of my own because I didn't have time to edit it. Editing takes long time even with a new editor. So let's go meet Penny. Also I would just no I'm not going to look at that. I'm not even going to look at the screen. Apparently Beatrice is available as friend, and as much as I understand Beatrice is a good addition, but why is Dobby here? I mean, I know Dobby is like the most famous house elf, and I know there is a Meet the Malfoys time limited side quest coming, but yeah, we don't need Dobby as a friend. I mean, that's just my personal opinion, but why is Dobby even available? We don't need Dobby. This is thus not useful. I don't know, man. I mean, Beatrice is good. Beatrice is good. Beatrice, I'm happy about. I've always wanted Beatrice as a friend. Okay, let's meet Penny now. Okay. Sky Parkin may be the only person who can outfly me. No kidding. I am pleased that Miss Parkin has made a full recovery. I see. Right. Miss Parkin's performance on the pitch was perfectly textbook. Yeah, that's great and all. Wait, where is Sky? Has anyone seen Sky? Sheesh. Everyone's talking about your house match, Rahi. Even Madam Pince, and she never talks about anything. I love how she says that with such enthusiasm. It was a rather spectacular win, wasn't it? Absolutely brilliant. You were fantastic, of course. Now, the problem with beta Quidditch these days is that Quidditch isn't a game mode. It is just a place where Jam City hides all their ditches. Not only do we already have the uniform glitch, but now we have the red hair glitch too. And that is not even a glitch. That comes from the fact that they implemented default hair colors into the game. Why did they do that? It was perfectly fine the way it was. The default hair colors just like gave a few good colors for hairs like Tonks' hairstyle. And it just glitches the Quidditch hairstyle because under the helmet our hair turns red. And I don't like that. I had to headcanon that he wears a scarf under it. It's actually not a bad headcanon because my dad does the same thing. Like under his helmet he wears a scarf to avoid getting sweaty, so that's a thing. But everyone's talking about Sky. They're saying she's my Hufflepuff Funge match. I mean, sure. It's like we're finally seeing Sky Park in Quidditch Star. Yeah, that's great and all. Shame that I can't play Quidditch and watch it at the same time. I had no idea. I mean, it's great that Sky is also. I mean, Sky is a... Wait, no, what is the word? I forgot the word. Of course, we won the match thanks to Sky. We won't win the match without Sky. No, I'm not counting the last chaser match that she didn't play in. Don't worry, Sarahi. I may not have Murphy's memory, but I'm sure I can tell you everything. Yeah, do tell. Penny truly is Sky's biggest fan. When Sky is on a chocolate frog card, it'll say she was Hufflepuff's best chaser. Aw, that's so cute. I hope Ethan Parkin comes to the match again. Sky made the Parkins proud. Of course she did. She's awesome. Sky swooped in and stole the quaffle from the chaser's hand. I mean, I had to focus on the blazer so I couldn't see it. It's good that Sky recovered so well after what happened last season. I mean, literally, last season. Sky says she's been practicing even more than before. Suppose it works. That's great. I still haven't asked the chance to ask Sky why she said her dad was injured. Yeah, I'm still a little... I still don't know why she's mad at me. What did I do? What did MC do? A goal backhanded. That is so cool, man. Honestly. Yeah. Sounds like I missed a lot. I haven't watched Sky play since she saved me in her first friendly. Between learning to play Quidditch and joining the Hufflepuff team, I haven't had the time. We'll watch her play in the Quidditch World Cup one day. I'll save you a seat.
Thanks.
Come to think of it, this is the first time you haven't been the talk of the team. How do you feel about that?
I'm honestly relieved.
It's a relief not being the center of attention.
Yeah, I am honestly relieved. I hate being the center of attention.
Thanks to Jacob, everyone has known who I am since I got off the Hogwarts Express. That's true, isn't it? In that case, I'm happy that you're finally free from the spotlight.
Yeah, no kidding. People like the spotlight, I run away from it.
Hey, Sky.
Yeah, I want to join these people in cheering, honestly.
That's my friend. Uh-huh. Why are you still standing around? Orion's called a team meeting. He probably wants to tell us who we're playing in our next house match. Gryffindor. Go on, Sarahi. I'm sure everyone's waiting for you in the changing room.
I suppose this... I have learned which team is... Yeah. I suppose that part was actually supposed to like start a rivalry between you and Sky, but that completely depends upon what option you choose. I'm honestly perfectly fine with it.
And he's over there. Wait, I don't want to press the wrong button. Hold on. Any idea who we're playing next? I'm a bit nervous. How have you been, Sarahi? Keeping busy? Is that supposed to be a keeper pun, by the way? Bean says you've got to work on your beater's bat technique, but you've got potential.
Oh, right, Bean. I completely forgot about Bean.
Is it time for a moment of evocation, Orion? Not usually a fan of those, but we deserve a bit of celebration after our win in our first house match. Especially you, Sky. You've never played better. Just wait until our next house match. Nice. Indeed, it is time to begin our preparations for our second house match.
Second house match is against Ravenclaw?
That makes no sense. I mean, I suppose they're not the Quidditch Cup champions anymore, so we don't face them last. Are we ready for that? We must be. And why does Orion sound like Marula? With our win in our first house match, we have sent a strong message to our competition. Winning with a score of 260 to 110 is something to be proud of.
Yeah.
It all comes down to getting the next Quidditch Cup match. Wait. We played Slytherin. If we're playing Ravenclaw next, then the Gryffindor will be the last match we play. Will be the final match for the Quidditch Cup. We have claimed that...
Why does Orion sound like Marula?
The developers are using the wrong voice lines for the game. We have claimed the title of Quidditch Cup champions. They will try to take it back.
Yeah, I mean, because if, again, he sounds like Marula. Because if Ravenclaw does win, which they won't, by the way, if Ravenclaw does win, then they face Gryffindor in the last one and they become champions again, more or less. Because if it was Ravenclaw against Gryffindor, whoever wins becomes the champion after. But of course, Ravenclaw won't win because why would they? We won't let them. They've got the best beaters at Hogwarts. Not sure we can match them.
Excuse me, I'm standing right here. Not without the world's next best professional Quidditch commentator. And certainly not without... Wait, what? This is the first time he's showing this to everyone. Beater defying strategies. Murphy has agreed to prepare us for our upcoming match. Listen carefully because I'll tell you everything you need to know about strategizing against beaters.
I am confusion.
Also, I should have turned auto clicker on. A bludger batted by a beater can strike at any and all angles.
Yeah, no kidding.
As we are all beaters, so are our opponents all beaters. That makes no sense. McNally and his maths. Maths don't win matches. It more or less does. Heed the wisdom of McNally. Like 83.7% of what I'm telling you is 73.4% effective. Dude, that's not very never mind. Perhaps I should ask Murphy about defying beta defying strategies.
This is what I was thinking about. Like, what about the beaters? Why are we focusing only on Peters? Because Erica Rath is a beast. Honestly, follow the strategy to increase your chance of beating a beater by 67.3%. But how am I going to define beater defying strategy? I'm pretty sure Ravenclaw team has them too. If you can't avoid a bludger, try to soften the blow. Why? Try to get behind Rath when she's aiming bludgers. Because blind spot, yes. A bludger batted by... Okay, you know what? We are out of line. I'll finish this and come back. Okay, we're done. With these tactics, will these tactics really help us win the Quidditch the house match? I can't read. Ew. Ravenclaw may have the toughest beaters around. But if you follow these exact strategies, you've got 53.8% of victory. I want to fear the odds, but I actually fear their reaction. So I'm just going to question it like a normal person. 53, that's not what I meant. 53.8%? How can you be so sure you're right, Murphy? How can you not be sure I'm right? You've not been a beater for long. True. This is true. I'm not going to question it. What are the odds that we can end this team meeting and get out on the pitch? It is indeed time for our team to convene on the pitch. There will be more than one surprise today. All this talk about beaters feels a bit personal. Come on, Sarahi, less standing, more flying. You have still not talked to me. Albi there has simply got lost in thought. Well, hurry it up. Can't beat Hogwarts' best beaters if you don't practice. You're right. It's time to head to the Quidditch pitch. Okay, how many friendlies do I have to do? I've been saving up gems. How many friendlies will I have to do? 2. Okay, that's an improvement. I'll do 2 friendlies and I'll get back after that. Okay, I did my friendlies and we literally just practiced Sky. Time, what do you mean time for practice? We literally just did that. What the hell did I do when I just did friendlies just now? Let's go. Sky has been cheerful ever since the house match. That's good and all. Will she talk to me now, please? You know what could be a laugh? Bludger table tennis. My dude, that is so freaking genius. Orion said he's got another surprise for us. Any ideas what it could be? I have no clue. Bludger table tennis? Imagine the number of broken bones in that. Oh god. Okay, now he just sounds confused. It is time. Are you prepared, Sky? Prepared for what? Orion's letting me run the team through some drills. Our team will benefit from an exercise they have not yet encountered. One beyond the borders of the typical. And you're letting her? I'm not sure any of our team exercises have ever been typical. Lucky for you, Sarahi, you've done this one before. Oh my god, 3 bludgers? Alright, you lot.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Does this involve 3 bludgers? Oh boy. To prepare our team for Ravenclaw's beaters, Sky will guide us through an unorthodox exercise. We're going to try something from when I taught Sarahi to play chaser. Wait a moment. Yep, I know it! I freaking knew it! I called it! Wait a minute. It's like, MC's reaction was like mine. Yeah, wait a minute. She beats 3 bludgers, doesn't she? Oh boy, here we go. Pair up and dodge the bludgers. Holy crap, that's not even 3 bludgers, that's like 6. I can't even count. This is like 6 bludgers over here. I mean, I suppose it's a good way to teach people to dodge the bludgers, but where the hell did you get that many bludgers from, Sky? Where did all those bludgers even come from? Honestly. glad I'm wearing my uniform for this. What? Alright, I was wearing a t-shirt last time. Gotta make sure everyone will come out of their house match with their ribs intact. I mean, yes, that is... Should I practice deflecting bludgers instead of dodging them? No, sometimes the beater has to dodge also, so that's okay. How did Sky persuade Orion to try this? And where is Orion? Where'd he even go? We just need more dexterity than... I have no idea what that word was. Girl looks like she's having a laugh. She's almost tearful. We'll need speed to win the house match. Speed and finesse. Wait, since when do you care about finesse? Oh my god. He's just like old times, isn't it? It kind of sort of does. But I'm getting a little scared. Try rolling to the side. Always helps. How did you even get this many bludgers, Sky? You can soften the blow if you sort of catch the bludger with your body. Wait, really? Does that actually work? Is that how I'm saving the seeker every time? I mean, at least Sky is being careful about it, but how did you even get that many bludgers? That is my question. Let me just finish this because we're out of dialogue and this is long. Okay, we are done. I mean, at least I hope. Need a breather, Sarahi? Definitely. Dodging bludgers is exhausting. And that's like 6 bludgers. Just like old times. I believe we have dodged a sufficient quantity of bludgers for the time being at least. Please, yeah. Let us breathe before we resume practice. Can we please keep these down for now? Orion, may I ask you something? Of course, Sarahi. Questions are the noblest of all quests, what? Well, even though we won our first house match, Murphy taught the team strategies to use against beaters, the best beaters at Hogwarts. I know Rats is rather good, but does that mean we aren't? What makes any beater good or bad? The terms are subjective, are they not? That is entirely unhelpful. But what if I'm holding the team back? Do you believe you are holding us back? No, I'm not holding us back. No, I don't think I'm our weak link. Then you have your answer. What? But I don't know for sure. How do I know if I'm holding the team back? The answer is inside you. The only certainty is in your heart. Oh, so he's basically saying don't doubt yourself, otherwise things will get worse. If my heart has answers, it's not keen on sharing them with the rest of me. The heart is abstract. Its answers are equally nebulous. You will find them when the time is right. That is entirely unhelpful. I suppose if I want an objective answer, I'll need to talk to Murphy. Yeah, because he's just going to give cryptic answers after Quidditch practice. We literally just practiced. What the freak? Do I have to do friendlies again? Oh, no. I thought I had to do friendlies again. Okay, good. I don't. Wait, what? Fine. Okay, after the practice, I also had to do 2 friendlies. I just cut all of it out. Let's just go. Let's just go see Murphy. In addition to the practice, I also had to do 2 friendlies. Okay, now it is at times like this when I wish I was wearing trousers. Why do I not wear trousers?
Hey!
Hello! It doesn't even surprise him anymore. To what do I owe that entrance? Andre, I didn't think I'd see you up here. He just arrived before you did. Though I have to admit your entrance was much more stylish. Thank you. We're reviewing seeker strategy, but I'm sure we could talk about beta tactics. Actually, I could use some help with statistics and an objective perspective. I've been having some doubts about how I've been playing beta. All the talk about beta really like got to me. Like, wait, is this targeted at me? Is this about me? So he came to the world's next best Quidditch commentator? Huh. I'll help too, since I don't play in house matches. I'm as objective as I am well dressed. Hey. Come on, Sarahi, we need details. K. Fine. Wait, dude, it takes me 8 hours to give him details. What the freak? You don't have to master everything on your first go. Natural talent is overrated. Perhaps I'm overthinking this, but I can't know for sure.
Urin Mari answers every question with another question. Bit ordering. Thank you. I love you very much. I've heard about this sort of thing before. It's both psychological and mathematical. What? Sky High, the team practiced dodging bludgers to prepare for the match. But why are we like fixating on bludgers so much? Did you teach the team strategies against Peters because of me? I don't... What? Penny says Sky is the talk of Hogwarts after our last house match. That's okay, I'm perfectly fine with that. That's the nice thing about being a reserve player. Far less pressure. You know, canonically, isn't Andre a keeper? He's not a seeker at all. He is the keeper for the Ravenclaw house team, not seeker. The beta defang tactics seemed relevant because of Rahath, not you. Don't forget that you haven't played beta for very long. It takes time. Okay. Okay, you know what? We're out of dialogue and I'm just gonna finish this because this is long. We're done. Whoa. It sounds like you're in a slump. What do you mean? Isn't slump simply another name for bad luck? Hey. Of course not. Luck is superstitious statistics. A slump, on the other hand, is purely mathematical. Hey. Every sport is judged by numerical points, averages, scores. You've got to account for every variable. Oh my god, I hate maths. I hate maths so much. Hey. Like your opponent's skill or what you ate for breakfast. Why does what I ate for breakfast matter? I'm hungry. Hey. Or the angle of the... Okay, I suppose that matters. Or the angle of the sun. But if your scores fall by 35.5% more, you're in a slump. That's one way of looking at it. Do you think you're in a slump, Curse Breaker? I don't even understand what a slump is. No, I am not. No, I'm not in a slump. A slump sounds rather dramatic. And beater is my dream position. Come on. In fact, I was just telling Orion that I don't think I'm holding the team back. Nobody is holding the team back. Though I probably need to improve as a beater before the house match. That's a good idea since you'll play Rath soon. And there's only one way to prepare you for that. You've got to get out of your head and back in the game. It's the same thing I told you when you were fretting over your friendship with Sky. That being said, she has still not talked to me. Who played spectacularly in that house match, by the way. Quite. She was at her most parkin. 100% parkin. That is so cute. Yeah, she's been in rather good mood about it too. I suppose you're right about getting out of my head, Murphy. But how? My head is where my mind is. Okay, that's a good line. My head is where my mind is. Come on. Going back to the basics always helps me when I'm trying to learn a new maneuver. Huh. Or trying to come up with a new outfit, huh? That makes sense. I can train a bit on my own before our next practice. Thanks, you two. I'll head back to the pitch. You are on the pitch. If your heart is still flooded by doubt, the Quidditch may calm the waves. What? I have enough gems, so I'll... I had enough gems right now, so I thought, yeah, let's just use it. Oh, I don't understand. What did he say? Hey, Sky. Are you actually gonna talk to me now, please? Sky, what are you doing here? Getting in a bit more practice before Orion shows up.
Oh.
Winning one house match isn't an excuse to slack off. Why are you here so early? Murphy says I might be in a slump. Really? What did you say? I don't think I'm in a slump, but practicing more can't hurt. If it helps, I know all about slumps. Because you've been in slumps yourself?
Uh-huh.
Of course not. Did you not see our last match? No. Well, no, I was playing in it. Right. Almost forgot. Sorry. You've been in a good mood ever since, though. And you were in a good mood when you were the star. Yeah, I wasn't comparing us. There's no comparison. I don't understand. Sky, are we alright? Things have been odd. That thing about your dad. Forget it. Listen, about your slump. Even professional Quidditch players get into them from now and then. You should hear some of the things they do to get out of slumps. Alright, let's hear it.
okay, at least Kai is talking, but I'm still concerned about the thing with her dad, okay? So why, Kai, please! Doesn't her mind toss puff skins back and forth to practice passing? Aw, that's cute! My brother talked to his lucky glove to get out of a slump. It worked though. Perhaps the way out of a slump is learning to laugh at myself. Between slump cures and lucky rituals, Quidditch players are a superstitious lot. I mean, are you having me on? It's difficult to tell. Sarahi, try giving one of my exams, and then talk about superstitions. I've still not done my exams, and I will not put my fear in Bubuter pass under any circumstances. Every slump remedy involves something ridiculous. It's like fighting a boggart. That's cool, man. That is so deep. One player, can't say who, washes his uniform in homemade jam. What? Why? Never been in a slump myself. Not since I was in nappies, anyway. Yeah, I mean, jam? My dad knew a keeper who swore by hanging from her broom, like a bat. Okay, I'm just gonna finish this now. I am very interested by the man who washes his uniform in jam. I can't believe some of the things Quidditch players to do to get out of the slump. These can't possibly work. Doesn't matter. The point is that they believed them. So, what do you believe would get you out of a slump? Andre says I should practice the basics for a while. Good advice. That's why I picked dodging bludgers for our team exercise. It was useful back when I taught you to play Quidditch, so it has to help us face wrath. Took a lot to persuade Orion that it made sense. But my training helped you, didn't it? Definitely, it definitely helped. Yes, I'd say it helped. I wouldn't be the Quidditch player I am without your training. That's why we'll win our next house match. And if you need anyone to send bludgers after you for practice, let me know. One way or another, you'll be back on form in no time, so long as you keep practicing. Now, are we going to stand around all day or are we going to play Quidditch? Perhaps we should chat some more first, since you're in a better mood and all. You keep saying that, yes, I'm in a smashing mood. What of it? What you told me about your dad being injured? Oh, come on! This is ridiculous! I wanted to talk to her! Remember, next up you've got Ravenclaw and Rats. I never need to talk to this guy. Practice! Yeah, sure, let's just practice. God damn it. I'm like just gonna skip over the match. Okay guys, we'll get back when we're done. I was meant to cut this match out, and while I did cut out the first part. Did you see that? With 1 second to spare, I got a perfect. Also, that move that my baby did was just like awesome. We knocked the bludger out of their hands as they were trying to make a call. That was awesome. Okay, now back to the cut. 3 friendlies. Are you actually kidding me? I don't have enough gems for this. Okay, it said task 5 of 5. I assume we're done with this chapter. Alright, we're done. We're done here. We are so done. We are done. We are actually done. I am out of here. I'm a bit salty because I nearly got a perfect match on that one, but I screwed up at the very last mini game. I almost got a perfect match. Okay. Anyway, that's all. We're done for today. When will we get to talk to Sky? This was funny before, but this is just ridiculous now. Wow, how is this a 49-minute record? Oh my god, this is going to be a pain to edit. This is going to be like 5 GB large, I don't know, for some reason. Anyway, yeah. When are we going to get to talk to Sky? I really want to talk to her. Anyway, I guess this episode is done.
The Quidditch storyline, it has less filler compared to the main storyline, mostly because the Quidditch storyline is shorter in comparison. It only has 4 seasons. So I suppose that's good. I think we have story chapter next week, hopefully. Also, I am still questioning the thing with Beatrice. No, I am not even looking at that. Nope, just get it out of my face. Get it out of my face. Look, I am happy about Beatrice. I've always wanted Beatrice as a friend since we met her. I am questioning why is Dobby here. I mean, I'm sure there are people who are going to be very happy about being friends with Dobby, but I am not. I am personally only happy about being friends with Beatrice. Dobby, I just don't. I don't understand. I do not actually understand why Dobby is an option. Why, if we can make friends with Dobby, why can't we make friends with Pitts? Pitts, who literally has stuck by our side for 2 years at this point, can have Dobby. Why can't we have Pitts? And if Dobby is a friend of and if Dobby is such a close friend of MC that he is literally in the friends list, then the first of all, he would still be working for the Malfoys. And second of all, he would have mentioned us to Harry at some point. Because MC is certainly the kind of wizard of witch who gets talked about a lot, even after the story has ended. So I'm beginning to question everything right about now. Okay, the chapter is over. This recording is ridiculously long and it's going to be a pain to edit. And on that note, I end this episode. If you enjoyed the episode, please like the video, subscribe. I know, you've already subscribed. If you're watching the video, you've already subscribed. Like the video, comment. I like comments. I read all of them all the time. And if you're new, then subscribe. If you like my content. You like it, right? I tried my best to make it likable. I really do, I promise. Okay? So, bye and have a nice day!